Well, it's 5:30 and already the road's busy. Watcher, so here we are, back in this swim for another short morning session. The weather today, it's going to rain, apparently. We'll see. Winds, again, coming from south-southwest, veering, so we'll see what happens with the weather. At the moment, it's nicely overcast. I'm not seeing anything show. I've not put any bait out either, because I put in 2 or 3 kilos yesterday, about a kilo and a half on each spot. There's a lot of fish in here. They turn up, they're going to eat all of that real quick, and I want them to get used to finding bait when they swim. Right, I made myself a coffee already with a percolator, so I'm going to sit down, drink that. So, like I say, I haven't put any bait out because I put in at least 2.5-3 kilos yesterday when I left. So, a few bits and spots of rain are coming, so I've actually brought the umbrella with me today, so I might have to put that up a bit. I think we're going to get a bit of early rain, and then it's not going to rain until later, so I might be gone by then. Depending on the weather and the day, I don't have to go to work. I've got today and tomorrow off, as it were, because I work all the rest of the week and the weekends. So I am thinking, you know, could put in a full day, right? So yeah, the idea is just to try and find a swim that I can fish consecutive 2, 3, 4 mornings a week. Well, 3 mornings really, because we only get 3 mornings, so you got to be off by 10 o'clock on a Friday morning, and you can't get on until 10 o'clock on a Monday morning, so that's 2 mornings of the week gone completely. So I've only really got Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday mornings. So that's basically why I've tried to arrange my days off for Wednesday, Thursday, and I work Tuesday and come down in the morning and just do the morning. So choosing a swim to fish for 3 or 4 days and keep the bait going is going to be difficult, because I could come down and someone could be bivvied up in it, and that'll be it. I won't get in for another 24, 48, 72 hours or whatever. So, yeah. I don't want to bivvy up unless I absolutely have to, because it's a lot of hard work. This is a lot of hard work, coming down every morning, moving your gear in and out of the car, in and out of the car. Rush hour, noisy, noisy. So I've moved my kit, put my umbrella up just to get me out of that wind, because I was getting chilly. Sunshine a little bit through the clouds, warming me up. So, fine. I was hoping for a run by now, haven't had one. Normally around this time the traffic slows up a bit and it goes real quiet, actually, well, comparatively. See on the other side of the road there, they've got hotels. They've got that fence up. That's what we need on this side of the road. I doubt very much whether we'll get one of those though. It'll probably cost, well, it will cost tens of thousands of pounds to fence the 3/4 of a kilometre. Where this lake is. Cost a lot of money. A lot of money. But you know what I think? It's just as important to keep the noise out as it is to keep the otters out. I really do. It would improve the fishing here, you know, the ambience of the place considerably. I can't ever see it happening. Oh well, we've just popped out of tent. I thought I'd show you it, because It's quite a decent size one actually. There you go. That ain't bad at all, is it? It's about 4 or 5 pounds. So let's slip that back, let's get the rod out. That was the inside line as well, so it's pleasing to get a bite. Well, it's nice to get a bite. Basically, that tells me that there's not so much bait out there as there was when I first put it in, of course. Because normally you don't get a bite if there's too much bait out there. What happens is you just don't get a bite. And I think that's possibly what's happened with me this morning. I think putting in a kilo or so in each swim, it was about 0.5 kilo too much for each swim, I think. Now, there is a lot of carp in here, but I don't think they're moving into here as much. I don't think there's so many fish moving into this part of the lake as what there is in that part of the lake. And most of the fish in that part of the lake tend to hole up at the back of the islands in the outbounds area, so they don't play no part. So I think careful baiting is what's needed at the moment. Normally I ease my way in a little bit easier, but I just felt yesterday that this swim could do with a good baiting. And it may still stand me in good stead today, you know. As the day wears on, it's supposed to be raining now. At least the weather's not so bad. It's certainly worth staying, you know, when the weather's like this. Because you can get bites, you know, into the afternoon, so. Well, I've moved the umbrella because basically the wind couldn't make up its mind whether it was going to come from the left or the right. So I've just basically got it. So the rain's now coming down. It's an hour later than it said on the weather forecast. Fish rolled not far off the left hand wall. So
I love the way you're dressed for summer.
Yeah.
Lovely old boy. Everybody on here is really nice. Met so many really sort of relaxed carp anglers. It's nice, you know. So I think I'm definitely going to stay here while it's raining and not move. But you know what? I think I need to put the cap. I do like a bit of rain. I've got to be honest with you. Not if it goes on and on and on and on and it's cold. But it's coming from the south. It's warm, it's not cold, and we need the rain, so not a bad wind. Could get a bite today, could get one. Lock time. So I'm still here talking to Jim. We were watching fish showing here and there. I put the deeper out a little while ago and found out something I didn't know, which was the drop-off went just a bit further out than I thought, so I repositioned my inside line, put a little bit of, give me that water bottle, could you, Jim? A couple of chops or so on it, because I didn't want them rolling down, I wanted them to stay good.
Slightly,
yeah. The left-hand rod went off, and I'll be honest with you, I thought it was a tench to start with. It was just donking, and then all of a sudden it decided to fly off. I didn't want to give up. So there you go. So a little bit of damage which I've already treated with propolis, but I will treat it again when I put it back in the water. A bit of damage from spawning, I think. What did we say, 27?
27 and a half pounds.
How jammy can you get? So, this is the tench. I'm well pleased I stayed a bit longer. It's a chunk. It's a chunk. Well happy. I really didn't think I was going to get a fish today. But when they all started shining here, I just had to stay. Right, I'll just quickly spin it round. Get the pick of the other side as well. It's pretty much the same. Fingers up. go. Happy days.
Good old whip on, isn't it?
That's well broad fish, wasn't it?
Mm. Right decision to stay, wasn't it?
That was a good decision to stay. Well chuffed. Well chuffed. I still can't believe I thought that was a tench. I mean, all I could see was like green. And it was bonking like that. I think it just didn't know it was hooked. And then all of a sudden, off it went. What a chunk. Really fat as well. So I put another handful of bait out on each rod. Left hand rods had halved baits because I'm just slightly on that slope. I don't want it to roll. Right hand rod is right at the bottom. I'm going to stay for another hour or so. I'm going to have to go then because I'm getting hungry. I've got no food. I've got no water left. I can't even have a cup of tea. So it's really hard. Don't you laugh? It is. It's really hard. I'm well chuffed though. I got a fish. I think I perhaps, like I said earlier, overdid it with the bait last night. You know, a handful of, again, one or two handfuls, enough for one fish. That's really what you should be doing. So I think I'll stick to it. Well, I thought you might want to see the otter fence. So, I've had my slow pack away, all the kit stowed. Just hanging on for just a little bit longer. I must admit, I've stayed in this swim a lot longer than I thought it would today. Glad I did though. I think I probably put a little bit too much bait in last night, didn't help. I think a few fish probably have been coming through because I've been seeing fish. And they finally munched their way through it. But well pleased with that fish, because after I put the deeper out and I sussed out that this drop off goes out a bit further than I thought, and I just managed to pinpoint the bottom area where I wanted to get to, put a lead on it, handful of chops, and about I just think within an hour I had that fish. So yeah, happy that I got a result for something that I've done. It's not just a pub chuck, not just a, you know, chuck it here, chuck it there. I've worked at that one, and I'm pleased. I'm well pleased with both fish that I've had this week. So hopefully there won't be anybody in this swim tomorrow morning when I arrive here. I will be getting here very early, before first light for sure. I haven't seen a fish hoik out for a while now, but there was a few doing it here and there a little while back. So there's a number of anglers have moved on to the lake. I think there's at least four or five around there, and there's a couple at least down here. So it's getting pretty busy down here again. Right, well, if anything happens in the next 10 minutes or so, I'll let you know. Otherwise I'll see you in the morning. Both rods are out. It's about 5:10, morning. So I was up at 4:00 this morning, sitting in the kitchen. Woke at about 3:30. Lay there, looked at the clock, thought, it's a bit early, Steve. Couldn't get back to sleep. Started thinking about fishing, that was it. So I got up, sat in the kitchen for a while, packed the car, and I was here by about 4:30. and it's just got light. So we had a fish yesterday. I had to stay. I wasn't going to stay much after about sort of 2 o'clock, but then when the wind sort of switched round and I started spotting one or two rolls and that, there was a fish over there, common, 20 plus common, breaching right out of the water. I just thought, right, I'm staying longer. And then I got the deeper out whilst I was fishing, because I thought, I just want to know. So I popped it over there about 4 or 5 times, pulled it back, and basically what I found was that the drop off here goes down quite steep, but then it sort of levels out just for a little way, and then when it gets right at the bottom, you've got this nice sort of little bit of a drop and a curve area, and that was really where I wanted to place my bait. So that's what I did. But if it went about an hour later, I think. When I had the fish on, well, it was a typical tench bite, the rod was bleeping away, the bite alarm, the bobbin wasn't moving, if you know what I mean. Just like that. So I picked up the rod and hit it anyway. And the rod tip just slightly bent, and it was just tapping like that. And I was just winding the fish in, and it was just tapping, tapping. And I was saying to the lad that was with me, Jim, this is a tench, another tench. We're both pretty convinced it was a tench. And it came up just under the surface, and we could see a big green tench, and it looked like a good size one. So I was taking it easy anyway. And all of a sudden, it woke up. And for the next sort of 5 or 10 minutes, I was just letting that thing run as much as it wanted against the clutch, just let it tire itself out. And when it came to the net, it was no problem at all. So, 22 and a half common? Yeah, 22 and a half common and 27 and a half mirror so far this week. I'm pleased with that. Well, it'd be 4 days this week. I started at 10 o'clock on Monday, which, to be honest with you, you know, you miss the first 5 hours of fishing. And I was wandering around the lake, backwards and forwards. But it was, even though it wasn't very productive in fish sense, it was quite productive in other ways. And it made me realise that this swim here was probably going to be my best chance. It's a fact that on a lot of fisheries, when I go to fisheries, I try and look for areas where no one else is fishing, or no one's putting a bait, or difficult to cast to, not necessarily technically, but just sort of something that's not quite as obvious to everybody else, that might hopefully be a little bit more obvious to me. So I tend to concentrate a lot on doing stuff like that. Now, with this whole bank closed off and that swim there, this channel area cannot be fished unless you fish it from this day swim or from the point and popping a rod around the corner. So it's a large area of the lake. I mean, the first swim is over there, right over there beyond that willow. So you've got this whole area of the lake here that basically there's no lines, no pressure. Now, I think the fish spend far more time in the main part of the lake than they do in here. But, you know, it was just like staring me in the face. So that's why I decided to try and get something going here. So I've been trickling bait all week long. I probably put about 5 kilos, 6 kilos of bait in here all told this week. I think when I'm fishing, it's just a handful or two. And I've decided last night that before I go, instead of popping a kilo in, which is what I've been doing, just pop in a couple of 3 pouches, which is what I did last night. I haven't put any bait out this morning, because I baited up last night before I left. Now obviously, I don't know how much bait is out there. There could be no bait out there at all. So I can put a catapult, a couple of, you know, another handful out without it really being too much of a problem, but certainly no more than that. Because if the carp haven't cleared that bait away, then it'll still be sitting there. So I've just had a recast on the left-hand rod and the right-hand rod, basically because I cast out in the dark. So exactly where I want the baits. This right-hand rod is not under that willow. It's well short of that because I want to be at the bottom of the drop-off. Same with the left-hand rod here. It's not just down in the margin. It's a lot further out because I want it at the bottom of the drop-off. Left-hand rod, I put a handful of halved boilies just sort of spread there. And the right-hand rod, very accurately, three boilies at a time, right on the lead out there, another hand.
Rod time. 10 to 7. So this one came about 10 minutes or so ago. Right-hand rod in the deep water. Fish was beautifully nailed. It's one of the linears out there, sort of linears. Yeah, that's right. One of the smaller fish, but still going to be a grower. This one's 16 and a half pounds. It's a nice fish, isn't it? Scrap. Absolutely screamed off as well. I wasn't paying attention at the time. There's always the way in it. Right, let's just quickly flip it round. There you go, it's been good. Hold on. Get it. There you go. Well chuffed. First fish of the day. Let's get them rods out again and another handful. It's working, isn't it? Well happy. It's got a couple of marks on it, which I'm going to treat quickly with propolis before I pop it in. A little spot there. And of course, the hook hold. Getting great hook holes, and the hook's just popping out beautifully, so I'm well happy with how everything is working at the moment. Stick it. Well, it's definitely time for second coffee, isn't it? Pleased with that fish. Well pleased. Lovely little fish as well. Right, so both rods are back out again, and I put another handful on that rod. Spot on, just absolutely spot on. Really concentrated this morning, trying to get everything right, and paid off, didn't it? Well chuffed.